how are you? This is Moushumi Dashgupta, assistant professor of Milestone College. Today I have taken your fifth class on fourth chapter, paper one. Let's start. So the students, in my previous class, I have discussed with you the derivation of Kp and Kc for different types of reaction, like synthesis of ammonia, decomposition of phosphorus pentachloride, decomposition of nitrogen tetroxide. Now, I discuss with you the derivation of Kp and Kc for the synthesis of hydrogen iodide. Here, I have taken rate of decomposition alpha. So, the reaction is when hydrogen, one mole hydrogen reacts with one mole iodine, then they form two mole hydrogen iodide. When time is zero, then the mole number of hydrogen is one, iodine is also one, and hydrogen iodide is zero, as our reaction started here. At equilibrium, it will be 1 minus alpha, it is also 1 minus alpha, and it is 2 alpha. Now we derive Kc, let the volume equal to V liter. So we have taken the volume as V liter. C of H2, that means molar concentration of hydrogen equal to 1 minus alpha divided by V, that means mole number divided by volume. Again, C of I2, that means molar concentration of iodine equal to 1 minus alpha divided by V. Because we have seen that at equilibrium, the mole number of iodine is 1 minus alpha and the volume is V. So, we have taken it is 1 minus alpha divided by V. C of HI equal to 2 alpha divided by V. Now, we derive the equation of Kc. You know, Kc equal to molar concentration of product. So, it is C of HI, as the mole number will be power. So, it is C of HI whole square divided by the product of molar concentration of reactant. So, it is C of H2 into C of I2. That means here we have seen that the formula of Kc is like that. Now, we put the value of C of H2, that means molar concentration of hydrogen iodine and hydrogen iodide, in this equation. And we have get that 2 alpha divided by V whole square divided by 1 minus alpha divided by V, 1 minus alpha divided by V. So, when we calculate the equation, we have found that in our upper portion there is 4 alpha square by V square, and in lower portion it is 1 minus alpha whole square divided by V square. Now, this V square and V square cancels each other and the equation is 4 alpha square divided by 1 minus alpha whole square. If we derive Kp for the same reaction, then we also found that Kp equal to 4 alpha square by 1 minus alpha whole square. So, we derive here Kp also. You have seen that Kp equal to let total pressure equal to P. So, total mole number equal to 1 minus alpha plus 1 minus alpha plus 2 alpha, it is 2. Now, P of H2, that means partial pressure of hydrogen equal to 1 minus alpha divided by 2 into P. Because you know this is mole fraction, partial pressure of any gas equal to mole fraction into total pressure. And mole fraction equal to mole number of any element divided by total mole number. So, it is 1 minus alpha divided by 2 into total pressure P. P of I2, that means partial pressure of iodine equal to 1 minus alpha divided by 2 into P. P of HI, that means partial pressure of hydrogen iodide equal to 2 alpha by 2 into P. So, it is alpha P. Now, to derive the equation of Kp, we put here the equation Kp equal to P of HI whole square divided by P of H2 into P of I2. Now, we put the value and the value is alpha P whole square divided by 1 minus alpha by P into 2 into 1 minus alpha divided by P into P divided by 2. If we solve the equation, it will be alpha square P square divided by 1 minus alpha whole square P square by 4. Now, if we solve the equation will be like that, 4 alpha square by 1 minus alpha whole square. So, this is the equation of Kp for the synthesis reaction of hydrogen iodide. Now, I discuss with you some maths of this chapter. The maths is, at 450 degrees Celsius temperature, 41.14 gram hydrogen reacts with 1325.88 gram iodine in 2 liter container. At equilibrium, 1308.16 gram hydrogen iodide is formed. Calculate Kp of the reaction. So this is the question. Now we solve the math. You know, in our Kp and Kc equation, when you derive Kp or Kc, then it will be related with the mole number. So we must calculate or convert this mass to mole. To convert the given mass to mole number, we know we should divide the given mass by the molecular mass. But you have seen that at 450 degrees Celsius temperature, 41.14 gram hydrogen reacts with 1325.88 gram iodine. That means here initial amount of hydrogen is 41.14 and initial amount of iodine is 1325.88. And see the last portion. At equilibrium, 1308.16 gram hydrogen iodide is formed. That means this 1308.16 gram hydrogen iodide is present at equilibrium. So this is the mole. This is the amount of hydrogen iodide at equilibrium. So let's start the math. First of all, we should write initial mole number of hydrogen equal to 41.14 gram divided by the molecular mass of hydrogen, it is 2. So we should get is 20.57 mole. So our answer is 20.57 mole. Now we should write initial mole number of iodine. So you have seen the initial amount of iodine is 1325.88. So it is 1325.88 divided by, it will be divided by molecular mass of iodine. You know it is 126.9 × 2. This mole. So the answer will be 5.22 mole. Now at equilibrium, because we have seen at equilibrium 1308.16 gram hydrogen iodide is formed. So at equilibrium mole number of Hi equal to 1308.16 divided by 1 plus 126.9. So it is 10.22 mole. So we convert the amount of hydrogen iodine and hydrogen iodide to mole. Now to calculate the value of Kp, first of all we should calculate the value of Kc, because you have seen here the volume of container is given, it is 2 liter. So now we should calculate the molar concentration of hydrogen iodide and hydrogen iodide. Okay, now we calculate rest of the part. So here the reaction is H2 plus I2 is 2HI. Now C of, that means molar concentration of H2 equal to, if we discuss it by taking our previous one, that means it is T equal to 0, 1, 1, then 0, at equilibrium, 1 minus alpha, 1 minus alpha, and it is 12. So, from the equation, you have seen that, from our calculation, you have seen that the at equilibrium, mole number of Hi is 10.22. That means this 2 alpha equal to 10.22. So we can write here 2 alpha equal to 10.22. That means alpha equal to 10.22 divided by 2. It will be 5.11. Again, V equal to 2 liter. You have seen here it is 2 liter container. it is given. So we can write C of H2, that means molar concentration of H2 equal to 1 minus alpha divided by V. Here this initial mole number is 1 according to our reaction, but according to our question, initial mole number of hydrogen is 20.57. So that's why we can write it in this way, that's 20.57 minus alpha, that means 5.11, divided by V is 2, it's mole per liter, it's mole per liter. So the answer is 7.73 mole per liter. This is the molar concentration of C of H2. Now come to C of I2. So it's 7.73 mole per liter. Now C of I2 equal to 1 minus alpha divided by V. Now we put the value, that means molar concentration of I2 equal to, you have seen the initial mole number of iodine is 5.22 minus 5.11 divided by 2 mole per liter. So the answer is 0.055 mole per liter. This is the molar concentration of iodine. Now we calculate the molar concentration of HI. So C of HI equal to, C of HI equal to 2 alpha divided by V. So it is 2 alpha divided by V, that means 2 into 5.11 divided by 2. And the result is mole per liter. The result is 5.11 mole per liter. So this is the molar concentration of hydrogen iodide and hydrogen iodide. I have repeat again. C of H2 equal to 7.73 mole per liter. C of I2 equal to 0.055 mole per liter. And C of HI, that means molar concentration of HI, equal to 5.11 mole per liter. Now we calculate Kc for this reaction. Now we calculate Kc. So Kc equal to molar concentration of HI whole square divided by molar concentration of hydrogen into molar concentration of iodine. We put the value here, 5.11 whole square divided by 7.73 into 0.055. If we calculate this, then the result is 61.41. So this is the value of Kc for this reaction. But the question is calculate Kp. So we know Kp equal to Kc into Rt to the power del n. Now del n equal to 2 minus 1 plus 1. It is 0. How it is 2 minus 1 plus 1? Because T is 2 is the mole number of HI minus the mole number of reactant. So it is 0. So Kp equal to Kc into Rt to the power 0. That means it is Kc. That means we can write Kp equal to Kc, it is also 61.41. So this is the result of this maths. Now I discuss with you another one maths of this chapter. Now I discuss with you another one maths. At 500 degree Celsius temperature and 50 atm pressure, A2 and B2 gas react with each other, and at equilibrium 25% ABH is formed. Calculate Kp of the reaction. So how can you do the maths? First of all, this 25% ABH, this is not rate of decomposition, because you know rate of decomposition means the percentage of any reactant which is decomposed. But here 25% ABH, that means this is product. So you can't tell that this is rate of decomposition. So our reaction is A2 plus 3B2 equal to 2ABH. Here this 2ABH formed is 25%. So you must think that as their percentage is given, that means total mole number is 100. From this 100 mole, 25 mole of ABG is formed. So rest of the mole number is of A2 and B2. Now let's start the math. Here at equilibrium, mole number of AB3 equal to 25. As here percentage is given 25. So at equilibrium, mole number of A2 and B2 equal to 100 minus 25 is 75. But students, you have seen that when one mole A2 reacts with then 3 mole B2 is also react. That means the total mole number between A2 and B2 is 4, as they are 1 mole A2 and 3 mole B2. Between this 4 mole, 1/4 of A2 is present and 3/4 of B2 is present. So our total mole number of A2 and B2 is 75. That means from this 75 mole, 1/4 of is of A2 and 3/4 is of B2. So you can write here it is 75 mole, it is 25 mole. As 1 mole A2 reacts with 3 mole B2, total mole number equal to 1 plus 3 equal to 4. So mole number of A2 equal to 1/4 of 75. 1/4 of 75. It is 18.75 mole. And mole number of B2 equal to 3/4 of 75. So it is, if we calculate 3/4 of 75, it is 56.25 mole. Now we calculate partial pressure of A2, B2 and ABG, as here total pressure is given, that is 50 atm. Total pressure is given, that is 50 atm. So you should calculate the partial pressure of A2, B2 and AB3. Now P of A2 equal to mole number of A2, you have seen in our calculation it is 18.75. So 18.75 divided by total mole number, it is 100, into total pressure, it is 50 atm. So we have find it. So we have find it 9.375 atm. Now P of B2 equal to mole number of B2, you have seen it is 56.25 divided by 100 into 50 atm. It is 28.125 atm. In the same way, P of partial pressure of AB3 equal to, you have seen that total at equilibrium mole number of AB3 is 25. So it is 25 divided by 100 into 50 atm. So it is 12.5 atm. Now let's start the calculation of Kp. So we calculate here Kp. Kp equal to P of AB3 whole square. P of AB3 whole square divided by P of A2 into P of B2 whole cube. If we put the value from here, we have find it is 12.5 whole square divided by P of A2. You have seen it is 9.375. 9.375 into P of B2. You have seen it is 28.125 whole cube. If we calculate it, the answer is 7.491 into 10 to the power minus 4 atm whole to the power minus 2. So this is the answer of this maths. So students, in my this 5th class, I discuss with you several derivation of KP and KC, several maths of these topics. I think you will be clear about these things. If you have any doubt, then you can text to your subject teacher or can text in myself also, to myself also. No more today. Stay home and remain safe.